two teams fighting hard for postseason eligibility clash Saturday night in Greenville. USF and East Carolina enter Saturday's game both with four wins, but time running out to get that sixth win for bowl eligibility and a few more weeks of practice. A bowl for USF would be their first since 2010 and a nice feather in the cap of third-year head coach Willie Taggart.
No more margin for error if we want to get what we want. You know, we want to win this conference. You know, we want to be able to play in the first championship game, and we want to win it. You know, and that's on us to do that. You know, but it all starts this week against East Carolina. We got to take care of them.
After this one with ECU, the Bulls have home games with East Division powers Temple and Cincinnati, and a rivalry road game at UCF Thanksgiving night. USF has been helped by the emergence of sophomore quarterback Quinton Flowers. The dual-threat QB has been averaging over 70 yards on the ground and recorded his second 200-yard passing game last week at Navy. 2 weeks ago, he set an American record for rushing yards by a quarterback, gaining 201 against SMU. The 27-19 defeat in Annapolis snapped a three-game winning streak for the Bulls, who are 2-2 in American play. Another key for USF is sophomore running back Marlon Mack. Last year's Freshman of the Year enters the game third in the conference with just over 102 yards per game rushing. East Carolina comes in off a disappointing 31-13 loss at UConn last Friday night. The Pirates were done in by four turnovers in the defeat that dropped them to 4-5 on the season.
And I've tried to tell everyone about this league from top to bottom. Each week, you see the teams, and you can't, margin error is real small. This is a big game. Glad to be back home.
In that one, both James Summers and Blake Kemp saw time at quarterback. Wideout Isaiah Jones and linebacker Zeke Bigger continue to be two of the keys for East Carolina. Jones has caught a pass in 32 straight games, while Bigger now finds himself just 10 tackles shy of breaking into the top 10 in school history. After this game with USF, the Pirates will head to UCF before wrapping up the season at home against Cincinnati. They'll need to win two of the three to keep their hopes alive for a fourth straight bowl trip. One thing in their favor, the Pirates have won six straight home games in November. This will be the sixth meeting between these teams. The Bulls won the first four, but East Carolina won last year's matchup. Kickoff is set for 7:30 p.m. Eastern Time on CBS Sports Network. For the American Digital Network, I'm Haley Allen.